Hi everyone, my name is Aisha Reizatin Laili. I'm 14 times 4 and my number is 5. On this occasion, I want to tell you about my story and title is Tobalik. Tobalik. Once upon a time, there was a poor fisherman who lived in the small village in North Sumatra. He lived alone. His parents had been long gone and he had not married yet. Every day, he went to the river in his village to fishing. It was the only job he had. One day, he only caught one fish, a big golden fish. It was the biggest kid he ever had. Then, he broke the fish to his home. When he arrived at home, he felt hungry and he prepared to cook it for his lunch. But when he held the fish and looked at it, he felt pity. He could not kill the fish because it was too beautiful. So, he decided to put it into the bucket full of water. Next day, as usual, he went to fishing again. But this time, he didn't catch any fish. He went to home with empty hand. Remember that the fish he caught yesterday? He planned to cook it. When he arrived at home, he wanted to take it from the bucket. Then, the fish wasn't there anymore. Instead, he found a beautiful girl sitting in this kitchen. "Who are you?" asked the fisherman. "I was the fish," replied the girl. The fisherman confused. "I was the fish you caught. You were so kind. You didn't kill me yesterday. For that, I'm very thankful. To return your kindness, I will help you to do anything," explained the girl. "Well, I live alone. I don't have any family. If you want to be my wife, I will be very happy," said the fisherman. The girl said, "Okay. But you must promise to me, if we have any children someday, don't tell them about my origin. If you break it, there will be a hug disaster." The The fisherman agreed and they got married. Few years later, they had a son named Samosir. As any other child, Samosir spent almost his day with playing with his friends. He played a lot and he never helped his parents. One day, Samosir was asking to deliver a lunch to his father. But on the way to his father, he met his friends and he decided to play with them. He forgot about delivering the lunch to his father. Moreover, he ate his father's lunch because he felt hungry after playing with his friends. On the other hand, the father, he is very hungry because he tired and hungry after fishing all day. Samosir's father decided to go home. On the way to home, he saw Samosir. Samosir, where you have been? You supposed to be delivered a lunch for me. I'm sorry, Dad. I forgot it. And I have just eaten it with my friends, replied Samosir. His father got very angry and showed him. You eat it? I go to work early in the morning and come back lately in the evening every day. So you and your mother needs are fulfilled. Do you even know? Oh, no. Damn you, son of fish. Hearing that, Samosir cried. And he ran back home to ask his mother. He told anything to her. Samosir's mother felt sad and he cried that her husband had been broken his promise. Suddenly, the sky was getting darker and the rain falling down. The rain was very heavy. It made the river flow. Within an hour, the village sank slowly. Before the village completely drowned, Samosir was asked to run up to heal with his mother. Meanwhile, his mother turned back into a fish. The fool met the village disciple. Samosir's father and all the villagers were drowning in death. It was only Samosir who saved. The legend said that the sinking village became a lake which is known as Tula Lake, and the hill where Samosir stayed became an island which is known as Samosir Island. The moral value is never break your promise and never let your anger take control of you. If it does, very bad will follow. Okay, everyone. That is my story. Thanks for your attention and see you.